How's it going, everybody? So this is me in the living room doing the part two of the game design seminar for Yesterday's Tomorrow, and here sitting next to me is the lovely and talented Jessica, who is putting together our website. So let me show you what that looks like.
Oh, hold on.
Dun, dun, dun! I don't even know if you can see that.
Yeah.
Can you see that? All right, there we go. So anyway, let's talk about your styles and what they do. So peril is a really important part of adventure literature. It's important for Doc Savage, it's important for The Shadow, it's important for Flash Gordon and for Buck Rogers and all the rest of them. So why not make it an important part of the game by making an actual mechanic out of it? Now, there is a mechanic called peril, and what happens is that every time your character is in some kind of dangerous situation, the Game Master gives you a point of peril. So you're walking down in the underbelly of the ship and you find a bomb in the engineering room. The Game Master gives you a point of peril. You walk into a room with your romantic character and you encounter two of your romantic interests, both in the same room, and they've been talking about you. Peril. The Game Master gives you a point of peril. You discover that your wife and daughter are being held over a pit of acid in a cage while the nefarious Dr. Zen gets ready to pull the lever to drop them into the acid. You get a point of peril. You kind of see where this is going. Every time that your character gets involved in a dangerous situation, you have peril. Now, like most role-playing games, when you want to resolve a scene that, like, your loved one's being held over a pit of acid in a cage with the villain holding onto the switch, you want to take a risk in the game. You want to invoke the game system. However, in Yesterday's Tomorrow, what happens is that you don't roll dice. You never roll dice. Well, that's not true. Sometimes you roll dice. But most of the times you don't roll dice. What happens is you tell the Game Master your intent, and the Game Master tells you the outcome, which usually means that the Game Master is going to complicate things in some way. The nefarious Dr. Zen pulls the lever, but and you pull out your gun and shoot at him, and the lever gets stuck, which means that your family is now dangling over the acid, and you have to do something because every once in a while the chain lapses and they fall a little bit closer, all that kind of stuff. So every time one of these things happens, you tell the Game Master your intent, and the Game Master tells you the outcome, which, like I said, generally means things get more complicated. It's a lot like the scene in the first Indiana Jones movie where they're trying to steal the plane. It starts off really simple. They try to steal the plane. Then there's a complication, which is somebody spots them. And then there's another complication in that Marion gets stuck in the cockpit. And then there's another complication where there's a big German guy who's beating up Indiana Jones. And then there's another complication in that one of the stops is moved and the plane is now turning around. And now there's another complication where Indy has to dodge the propellers. And now there's another complication in that there's gasoline everywhere and there's a fire. This goes on and on and on and on with the Game Master further complicating things, further complicating things, further complicating things. Now remember, every time the player's characters are put into dangerous or perilous situations, they get a point of peril. And what you use peril for is rolling dice. Whenever you spend a point of peril, you get to roll the dice on your character sheet. You roll a number of dice equal to your style, if it's appropriate. For instance, if you're fighting somebody, you get to roll your action. If you're trying to convince somebody of something, you roll your romance. If you're trying to deceive somebody or trying to be sneaky, you roll mystery. And if you're trying to use technology, you use your science. So you roll a number of dice equal to whatever your rank in those styles are. And the dice tell you how many successes you get. And based on those successes, each one allows you to say one thing is true about the outcome of the risk. So essentially what happens is, unless the players spend peril, the Game Master gets to further complicate the situation. Spending peril indicates the player's motive of, I want to resolve this. I want to resolve this scene. So the player spends the peril, they roll dice, and based on their roll, they get to say how many things are true about the resolution. Now, in playtests, this was kind of odd for a lot of players at first, but they quickly got over the speed bump and they started going lickety-split 80 miles an hour down the freeway. The whole idea about, I don't roll dice unless I spend points. Yes, you don't roll dice unless you spend points, which means the game master gets to go fast, fast, fast. There's no stopping for charts. There's no stopping to check numbers. There's no stopping. It's just complication on complication on complication upon complication. It's only when the resolution comes that the player gets to think for a second, how do I do this? How do I do this? So everything gets to build, build, build. It's all about momentum. Build, build, build. Until the very end when the player says, this is where I want it to stop. This is where I want things. This is how I want things to end up. So the Game Master gets to complicate things, and the players get to resolve them. And that's how Styles and Peril work in the game. There's a couple of more things to talk about. I'll do those in Episode 3, which will be up shortly, possibly by the end of the weekend, if you're all good boys and girls. And until then, be sure to check out the new website. It should be up with this video, right?
Yes.
Yes! Yes! And until then, something witty. I look so serious.
Yeah.